and Tilly viewers, we have just finished reading chapters 1 through 10 of Beauty Queens by Libba Bray. Let's dive in. So already I'm loving this book. I had so little idea of what it was going to be about, and it's so snarky and fun, and there's a lot of really interesting stuff going on. So first of all, I love the tone of the book. It's sarcastic and fun at the same time, which I'm really enjoying. I love the footnotes that carry throughout the story. That's a really nice addition. It's confusing right now how this book is set up. I'm not certain what the overarching theme and message is going to be, because the pageant girls that are really into the pageant are definitely being painted as airheaded and kind of shallow. I really doubt that this author is trying to just write a book about how stupid beauty pageant contestants are, so I'm very interested to see where this is going. There've already been a lot of little scenes that have really deep stuff going on. Like, really early in the book, Taylor thinks that Miss Colorado is an island native just because of how she looks, and even when she says she's from Colorado, Taylor thinks that's an island tribe or something. It's very clearly painting Taylor as a complete moron, and a lot of internalized racism going on right from the beginning. Obviously, it's making a statement on this. And that was just one of the scenes like that. Adina also has sort of taken a more of a narrator role. You see things from her point of view a lot more often than the other girls, and she's definitely set apart as this unique and interesting character who kind of sees the BS for what it is. She's usually the voice of reason when Miss Texas is trying to get everyone to practice their dance routines and work on their question answers. She's the one who's always telling them that they should build shelters and look for food, and I was very relieved when they all decided to finally do that, because 4 days of not doing that is insane. I really like how intense the things that have happened to them are, but how nonchalant they are about it. They've like accidentally eaten drug fruit and went on this like crazy jungle trip. One of the girls literally climbed her way out of a snake who had eaten her. This is some like super, super intense stuff, and the fact that so many of the girls haven't lost their head. One girl is walking around with a tray sticking out of her forehead. I can't even imagine what that looks like. The fact that nobody has like totally lost it yet is really a testament to how crazy pageant-minded so many of them are. I don't know how long it's gonna last. And then, of course, we get a little bit of a glimpse of whatever the heck is going on this island. Apparently, it has been reported that there were no survivors of this plane crash, which is immediately very suspicious. Operation Peacock is apparently a thing that's happening. We don't really know what it is yet. We got a little bit of background about weapon laundering and globalization of the corporation. But beyond that, there's some sort of weird conspiracy thing going on, possible terrorism. I don't really know yet. They've obviously kept it purposefully vague, so I'm sure we'll be finding out more about that. I really, really am enjoying this book so far. I'm very curious to know your thoughts. What are your thoughts on the corporation and the world that they live in? I'm also trying to figure out where this is set. I don't know if that's been made clear at all. I'm assuming it's the future, but it's kind of hard to say. Also, do you think we're going to see more deaths? I mean, they immediately killed off a bunch of the girls, and also all of the adults and camera crew and stuff, but of the girls that are left, do you think that we'll see any more deaths, or do you think they're all gonna make it? Let me know your answers to these things in the comments below. Let me know other thoughts and questions that you might have, and for next time, we'll be reading chapters 11 through 20. So thank you guys for joining me on my new book. I hope you're enjoying it, and I'll see you next time.